Southwest Conference on display, but the team currently from the Mountain West has recently owned the Big 12. I promise that will make sense in a second. Hey, how are you, folks? Jason Horwitz, glad to be with you on the Toyota College Football Preview Show exclusively here on CBSSports.com. It's 19th-ranked Texas Christian on its way to Austin to take on number 7 Texas. And for more on the Week 2 matchup, we bring in Spencer Tillman from Houston, as we will every single week. And Spencer, you're down there in Texas. TCU 5-0 against Big 12 teams since 2005. That includes a win at Oklahoma. Are people talking upset?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm talking upset. And by the way, this is like old time Southwest Conference action. You were just a little kid at the time. Breath probably still smelled like Similac. You don't remember those great days, but it was fun to be sure. Yes, upset. They beat Oklahoma at their place in the opener 2 years ago. And to me, Texas didn't look particularly strong in their opener. So they've got some issues at running back. Hopefully we'll talk a little bit about that. But TCU, behind Gary Patterson's leadership, is a tremendous football unit.
Let's talk about TCU's defense, Spencer. Last year was second overall in the country. Are they that good against this year?
Absolutely, and particularly against the run, which is problematic, and that's the reason why I'm looking at an upset here. 21 straight games, this TCU defense has not allowed an opponent, a rusher, to rush for over 100 yards, and that's problematic for Texas because Texas needs to get their running game on track to be effective. Colt McCoy looks good in his second year quarterback as a starter, but he certainly needs some help from the run game to be at his best.
Well, that defensive front for TCU last year, as we mentioned, second best total defense. They could get a boost. Defensive end Tommy Blake, one of the best on the team. As of Wednesday morning, questionable. He did not play in the opener for undisclosed medical reasons. In the meantime, you mentioned Colt McCoy. His sophomore campaign, it started off to a little bit of a rocky start. Who has to step up for him? Remember, no Billy Pittman. He's still suspended here.
Well, Jamal Charles, the running back, and he's a guy that's a track guy. And listen, historically, I don't get excited when I see track guys being asked to carry the ball 20, 25 times. They tend to be a little bit softer, and I'm not suggesting that he is, but his history has proven that guys that have been formerly speed-type guys that have been running track a lot of times are problematic when you ask them to be the every-down back. So Mac has got to flesh that out a little bit from the offensive standpoint, but we certainly know that he's got skills. I mean, the guy can run, he's tremendously fast, and he seems to be strong. He put on about 15 pounds in the offseason, still has that speed, and I think he's going to be problematic if they can get him going. 100-plus yards against Arkansas State last week, but trust me, TCU is not Arkansas State.
No, not Arkansas State at all, and in that Arkansas State game, it was only an 8-point victory for Texas. I guarantee Mac Brown was not planning on using his hands team in that ball game, which actually had to happen. All right, the Horned Frogs, they've dropped 14 straight in Austin. Does that streak end Saturday night?
Well, they're going to win it. Mac Brown's group is going to be prepared to play, but I'm telling you, this is going to be kind of like it was with Oklahoma at their place 2 years ago. It's going to be scary, but I think Mac will be able to leverage the tradition of Texas, and I think they'll come out with a 3-point decision. Believe me, for the second week in a row, we will be talking about a team that doesn't really have the marquee attraction and the attention of some of these other marquee programs, potentially upsetting a juggernaut like Texas a couple years removed from a national championship.
Had it not been for Michigan and Notre Dame, we would have been talking about that Texas game a lot more last weekend. All right, Spence, thanks very much. We'll get back to you a little bit later.
All right, Jason, my man, we'll see you, brother.
All right, folks, there you have it, a breakdown of what could be the upset special in the making. Spencer doesn't like TCU in this game. I do. I will take the Horned Frogs to upset Texas. It's the first meeting as ranked foes between the two in 23 years. For Spencer Tillman, I'm Jason Horwitz. For more on this game or any other in Week 2, stay right here at CBSSports.com. Take care.